2014 reactor here, and today we are finally looking at my Terminator Skull project, which I've been working on for quite a while. I've been off uploading YouTube videos for quite a while because I've just been constantly working on this. So this is an idea that I've had since about 2015, where I wanted a Terminator Skull that would be able to detect objects, detect humans, and be able to talk back to humans. So this is a culmination of my 2018 Raspberry project, my 2019 NVIDIA project, and my 2020 HK Tank project, as well as a bunch of other projects like my chatbot and my bot engine, which handles talking and getting responses back, and also the bot engine, which handles sentiment analysis for the things it's hearing and the things it's saying, so it allows a bit more depth in the responses it gives. So I just had to find the right Terminator head to get this implemented in. As you can see, my prior projects, the Raspinator and the NVIDIANator, they didn't quite look right. And then the HK Tank as well, I'll just show you that here quickly. Really nice. That's where I get a lot of the vision technology from, and also the queuing technology to allow it to do multiple tasks at the same time. But now I finally found this amazing skull off of eBay, and again, link in the description to the company that does it. Not only does it have LEDs for eyes that I can hook into the Raspberry Pi, but it also has the fact you can pop them out and have a blank eye socket where you can put a camera through, so it's absolutely perfect. Okay, so let's get a demo of it detecting objects, detecting me, listening to what I say, converting it to text, running through the chatbot and giving a response back by text to speech. And let's hope the demo works. Alrighty, so here we are booting up. You can see it's got Docker open there with Portainer. It's what holds the chatbot's database on in a PostgreSQL running container. So that's also going in the background. We're hopefully going to get a demo of it detecting me, listening to what I say in terms of speech, converting that to text, running that through the chatbot, and then pushing out the other side. We should hopefully be able to get some object detection done as well, as it can multitask. While it's inferencing speech, it can also be detecting objects. At the moment, the mission parameters have only been set to detect a human, and upon detection of a human, talk to it. It doesn't do anything else at the moment. So there it is. And if I go onto the screen, it should detect me as a person, and hopefully initiate speech to text. Hello there, how are you? Okay, there is inferencing speech. Okay, so that's going to take quite a while to run through that, unfortunately. I need to get the speech inferencing done on another core, ideally. So I've just got a little command window open there, which is just to show what that middle process is showing there, just to see how much lag there is between it showing on the screen and what's actually happening. And they seem to be pretty close, which is good, because obviously you don't want it saying it's listening 3 seconds after it's stopped listening. So we're testing on the fly a bit here. Okay, so while it's doing that, we can actually get it to analyze objects using the object detection algorithm. So I hold a cup up here. Should detect that. Hopefully. There we go. Cup, 90%. Let's just get a little bit of a closer shot there. Cup, 90%. And then it saw me earlier, 82% sure I was a human. And it can detect other objects as well, so it's not just humans. If I get this laptop here. There you go, let's pick that up as a laptop. 77% sure of that. And if it had mission parameters to do something when it detected an object, it would be putting those into the queue. And after it's inferenced the speech, after it's spoken back, then it would then continue to process those objects. So it can do multiple things at once, and then it will queue up the actions with certain priorities for what it needs to do next. So if it saw a cup and it was ordered to switch its LED off when it saw a cup, it would wait till it's done its interaction with me, then switch the LED off. Let's see if we can get it to detect one more thing. So detect a cup and a laptop. Let's get my phone here. It's detected me again. It's really good at detecting people, which is scary. That's what I want. Still detecting me. Cell phone, there we go. So it detected me. And then it finally detected my cell phone. So that's really cool. Really happy with that. And it takes about 5 minutes to inference speech, so hopefully that's coming up soon. Please work. Please work. This will be edited down, but it is all happening in one recording.
Oh my god, it picked it up. It said something else. It at least picked up the word hello.
Talking to idiots, and you.
Oh, yes. It did it. Oh, it did it. It listened to the text I said. It didn't quite pick up what I said fully, because the speech to text is still a little bit janky, but it picked up on it, and then it replied saying, I'm talking to idiots, how are you? Yes, it worked! Yes! Finally! An end-to-end demo of the Terminator skull working, and there we go, it's picked up on me again, and it's inferencing speech again. There you go, it can detect objects, it can detect people, and it can do custom missions based on what it's detecting, and I've just shown it there, detecting me as a person, talking to me, and getting a response back. And the chatbot that runs underneath it will keep that previous reply in mind, so it should be able to sort of continue on the conversation, hopefully. So there's the base skull itself. You can see around the side, the Raspberry Pi. It's a bit messy in there. You see there's a stand on the back to keep it balanced, like that thing that Homer invented one episode. And inside we can kind of see the hardware that's in there. So it's a bit messy. It's held in with a bit of Velcro, sticky stuff on the side there. It's not in there the best. What I need to do is get some sort of holder in there for the main board and then a few other things and a better way to hold the camera in there, because it's just kind of held in there with a bit of blue tack at the moment, which works, but so it needs to be a bit more solid so it can be taken out for demos and stuff like that. And also these wires need tidying up a bit as well. And also it needs to be solid, but also able to be upgradable. That's the hardware that's in there. You can see the BrainCraft hat in there and the Raspberry Pi 4 there. That's a quick look at the back. Hoping to one day maybe 3D print some sort of thing, a little shelving system that slots in there nicely, and get the camera in there, everything else plugged in, so it's stable but easy to remove everything out, because it is a little bit janky at the moment.
There we go. It's a little slow running all this stuff, and there's still a few bugs I had to work out while trying to get that demo video. It took ages, but we got there in the end, and you can see it's really cool. Like I said, it's a bit slow because it's running a lot of things at once. You can see there's discoloration on what it sees. That's because it's using a camera with no IR filter. In the right conditions, though, it does look red, which is cool, like Terminator vision. But it did indeed detect me there, put it through the mission parameters, determined that it needed to talk to me, listen to what I said, put it through the chatbot, and came back with a response that made sense, which is really cool. I think it misheard a bit what I said, but it got the gist of what I said. It got hello, and I think how are you in there. But the speech detection isn't fully accurate, because it's running offline, and also I think the fan inside makes a bit of reverberating noise in there, which can disturb it a little bit, but it still got the gist of what I said and gave a good response, which is really good. And while it was inferencing that speech, it was also still being able to detect objects, and if there was any missions it needed to do from those objects, it would put that into the event queue, allowing it to multitask. So once it finished talking to me, it would carry on with the rest of its tasks that it needs to do. So for instance, you could hook it up to the serial port on there via USB to an Arduino and have like a LED that acts as a plasma cannon and have it detect a loaf of bread and then fire plasma at it. The YAML is editable. You just need to edit in the events and extra core programming around what it does to respond to those events. So that's what I'm going to be aiming towards expanding in the future, its ability to do different actions depending on what it's seeing or what inputs it's receiving, and then allow that to be editable in the mission parameters YAML file. So you can essentially give it mission parameters while it's online, it will refresh the YAML and then change how it responds to it. Also, in future, I'm hoping to use that serial output to connect to a large exoskeleton. So this is just the beginning. This is an ongoing project that I'll be continuing to work on, modify and update over time, and this is going to be the base for it. I just need to improve the building of it. So it's a great platform to work from, really good. I'm hoping to add in some thought processing and also a longer term memory so I can remember things that it's doing, stuff like that. And hopefully in future, with more power behind it and code optimizations, and hopefully I can get it to use more cores, like a separate core for the speech inferencing, I can get it to run a lot faster. There we go. That is my Terminator skull project, because it's a culmination of a lot of work that's built up over the years, and figuring out how to hook it all together and get it all working, and then figuring out all the bugs to at least get it working to this point where it's still pretty buggy, has been pretty hardcore. So I would really appreciate if you would leave a like and a subscribe and a comment and share this video. Check out the Hackster pages, check out the Electromagic pages, check out the GitHub code. If you can try and build your own skull and get the code working on it, it might be a bit janky to get working because the requirements are quite complicated and TensorFlow isn't available on the PIP repo yet, so you have to install that manually, but the instructions for that are all in Hackster and Electromagic pages. Again, links below, check those links out. Go to the links and check those out. If you made it this far, thanks for watching, because it's been a long journey And now this video is finally done and it's working. I can now take a bit of a break, refocus, do a couple of other projects, and then come back to this at some point and update it. And tonight, I will finally go to bed, hopefully before midnight. Everyone stay safe, and I will see you in the next video.